He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Okay, this practice problem is going to be about significant figures, so let's take a look at the question. Number one, perform the following operations and list the answers with the appropriate number of significant figures. So we have an addition, we have a subtraction, we have a multiplication, and we have a division. And then next, we have another question. A sample of some metal weighs 39.15 grams. When placed in a graduated cylinder filled with water up to the 16.6 milliliter mark, the new volume reads 20.2 milliliters. What is the density of the metal? So this all has to do with significant figures. If this seems unfamiliar, go ahead and check out my tutorial on this topic before moving forward. And when you're all set, go ahead and give these questions a try. All right, let's take a look at these one at a time. First, we have 7.065 plus 4.9. So we can just go ahead and put that in the calculator, and we're going to get 11.965. But we have to remember the rule for addition and subtraction that states that the answer should have the same number of decimal places as the value with the smallest number of decimal places. So we have to look at the things, we have to look at the numbers we're adding, and we see that the first number has 3 decimal places, and the other value has 1 decimal place. So our answer has to have the number of decimal places as the one of those that has fewer. So the one that has 1 decimal place determines that our answer must also have 1 decimal place. So we're looking at 11.9, but remember when we're rounding, we have to look at the next digit. And if the next digit is 5 or greater, which in this case it is, we have a 6, that means we have to round our number up. So 11.96 is going to round up to 12.0. So that is our answer to 1 decimal place, and that's the correct answer for that addition. Now looking at the subtraction, 134.4 minus 55.77. We can go ahead and put that in the calculator and we get 78.63. Now once again, we're going to go by the same rule. We have to look at the number of decimal places. So the first value has 1 decimal place and the second value has 2 decimal places. So the smaller number of decimal places is 1 decimal place, so our answer must also have 1 decimal place. So we've got 78.6, and then we have to see how we're going to round this. And this is a 3, so we are going to round down, which means we can really just get rid of it. And our answer is going to be 78.6 with 1 decimal place. Now looking at the multiplication, 11.01 times 8.3. Again, we can just go ahead and put this in the calculator, see what we get. We get 91.383. So now let's remember the rule for multiplication and division. This states that our answer should have the same number of sig figs as the value with the fewest sig figs. So we're not looking at decimal places, we're looking at significant figures in general. So let's see how many we have. Our first value has 4 sig figs, and our second value has 2 sig figs. That means that our answer should have only 2 sig figs, because 2 is the fewer number of sig figs out of the numbers that are being multiplied. So now we have to look at the next digit to see how we're going to round it. That is a 3, which is less than 5, so we round down, and we can essentially just get rid of those decimal places, and our answer is going to be simply 91, which has 2 sig figs. And then finally, we have 267.954 divided by 109.0. So let's put that in the calculator. We get 2.45829, etc. There's a lot of decimal places. So now how many sig figs do we need in our answer? Well, our first value has 6 significant figures. And this one has 4. Remember that final zero, that trailing zero, is significant because it is a decimal zero. If it was to the left of the decimal place, if it was 1090, then that last zero would not be significant. But 0.0 is more precise than simply 109. So that is 4 significant figures. And that means that our answer should have four significant figures. We look at the next digit, that's a 2, so we are going to round down, and we can just get rid of everything to the right of the 8. So our answer is going to be 2.458 to 4 sig figs. Now let's look at this second question. Remember, we have a piece of metal with a mass of 39.15 grams, which we measured on a balance, presumably, and then we have some water in a graduated cylinder. It initially read a volume of 16.6 milliliters, and then we put the metal inside, and the new volume read 20.2 milliliters, and we want to find the density of this metal. So the density of any object is equal to its mass over its volume. And we have the mass of the metal, so all we need is the volume. And in this case, the volume of the metal is equal to the volume of the water displaced. So when we put the metal in the water, the change in the reading of volume on the graduated cylinder is equal to the volume of the metal. The metal has displaced exactly as much water as its volume. So what is the water displaced? Well, that's just going to be the difference in the two readings. So 20.2 milliliters minus 16.6 milliliters, that gives us 3.6 milliliters to one decimal place because each of those values has one decimal place and it is a subtraction. So we need one decimal place in our answer. And now lastly, let's just be sure to understand that when we're discussing volumes of solids, we typically don't use milliliters. It's more common that we could use centimeters cubed or cubic centimeters. And those are equivalent units. 1 milliliter is equal to 1 centimeter cubed. So let's just call that 3.6 cubic centimeters. Now we're ready to do mass over volume. So we've got the mass of the metal divided by the volume of the metal. And if we just plug that into our calculator, we get 10.875 grams per cubic centimeter. But let's be aware of sig figs in our answer. We see that the first value has 4 sig figs. The second value has 2 sig figs. And we are doing division, so our answer needs to have a number of sig figs that is equal to the fewer number of sig figs in the values that we are using here. So the 2 sig figs in the volume are going to dictate that we need to have 2 sig figs in our answer. So there's our 10, and then we look at the next digit, and that is an 8, so that is greater than 5, which means we need to round up. So 10.875 to 2 sig figs will become 11 grams per cubic centimeter. So that is going to be the density of our metal to the amount of precision that we are allowed given the values that we were using, and that is the answer to this problem.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials, support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.